Broomhilda, we need your help.
Yeah, we're still stuck in our Halloween costumes, even though Halloween is already over. Please, Broomhilda, we need your help.
You are? Well, I have a confession to make. I did that magic spell for the very first time, and I think you two may be stuck in your Halloween costumes for the rest of your lives.
What? You mean we're gonna be stuck in our Halloween costumes? Forever?
I don't feel like laughing right now. Yeah, I think so, but then again, I don't really know.
Well, Polly, what do you make of it?
Well, all I can say is, Cuckoo! 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 Cuckoo!
I agree! Cuckoo! 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 Cuckoo!
Cuckoo! Cuckoo! Cuckoo! Cuckoo! Cuckoo!
Cuckoo! Cuckoo! Cuckoo!
Oh, that's pretty funny! But don't go cuckoo on me, you guys! I have a solution! You see, my trusty cauldron will help you. Look, here's my cauldron right now. I will help you with the help from my cauldron in no time.
Uh-oh, are you going to cast a yucky witch's brew for us? I hope not.
What? Oh, no, no. You see, this is the state-of-the-art cauldron robot. Not only it's a magical cauldron, but it's also a robot. All right, robot cauldron, we need your help. We need a cure for Polly and Koki right now.
Affirmative, Master Broomhilda. I will scan for one right now.
Take a look at that, Polly. That is so amazing. Warning, warning, scanning has finally been completed.
Oh, good. Thank you, Robo Cauldron. What's the cure?
To take off your Halloween costumes, you must do a movie review of Disney's Beauty and the Beast. There is no other way.
Ah! Okay, thank you, Robo Cauldron. Polly, what do you make of it?
Well, we gotta take our costumes off, so let's do this movie review right away. Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a handsome young prince lived in a shining castle.
Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind.
But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered the prince a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away.
But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within, And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen there was no love in his heart. And as punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed by his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered is really an enchanted rose, which will bloom until the beast's 21st year. If the beast could learn to love and earn love in return, then the spell will be broken. If not, he will be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years went by, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Wow! Polly and Koki! That's pretty good! That was amazing! Yes, I have to admit, that was the best prologue I have ever seen. That's right, everyone. To take these Halloween costumes off once and for all, we're gonna review Disney's Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah, that's right, Koki. You know, I love Beauty and the Beast. It's one of my favorite Disney's classic. I mean, I just love Be Our Guest, the Beauty and the Beast song. Oh, wow. And heck, I even love the live-action reboot of Beauty and the Beast.
This movie is about Belle, who lives in a small town, and she loves to read books constantly, but the villagers think she is so different. And there's this Gaston guy, and he could be a real jerk killing animals with LeFou. And he wants to marry Belle, but Belle refuses to marry Gaston.
When Belle got home, she met up with her father, named Maurice, who is an inventor. Maurice feels like giving up when his invention is not working, but Belle has confidence in her father. And when Maurice finally got the invention going, he decided to go to the fair. However, when he got lost in the woods with Philippe the horse, he was being chased by hungry wolves.
Bad doggies. Bad, bad, bad doggies. You know, Koki, when I first saw this movie, I didn't like those wolves at all. I mean, they look so evil looking with their yellow eyes. Sharp teeth. They're so nasty looking. I prefer Balto over those guys. I mean, Balto wouldn't hurt a fly, but those guys, they chased Maurice constantly until Maurice finally got to the castle.
Yeah, and the worst part is, those wolves look even more nasty looking in the live action reboot. When Maurice finally got to the castle, he met up with Lumiere the Candle, Cogsworth the Clock. Oh man, those two are so funny together. Oh, and he met up with Mrs. Potts and her cute son named Chip. But he also met up with the Beast, who kinda locked Maurice in a dungeon. Anyway, Maurice is stuck in the dungeon by the Beast, but while he's stuck in the dungeon, Gaston still wants to marry Belle. Aw, man, what a jerk! Can't you just leave Belle alone for once in your life, Gaston? I know, you love to kill animals, you have super strength, but what does LeFou see in you, man? I mean, you're a real jerk. You know that, Gaston? guest on. Get your life together, man. Just leave Belle alone, for God's sakes.
Whoa, whoa. Koki, calm down. Gaston is not real. Do you hear me? Gaston is not real.
Sorry about that, Polly. My bad. Anyway, when Philip came home alone without Maurice, Belle knows something is wrong, and she asked Philippe to take her to the castle where Maurice is being held in a scary dungeon. Whew, I'm so glad Halloween is over. When Belle met up with the Beast, Belle makes an offer that the Beast must take Belle instead, and the Beast accepted that offer. Maurice refuses, but Belle is determined to save her father's life.
Yeah, she kind of got stuck in the dungeon at first, but then the Beast took her to a real room.
I am so glad the Beast had a change of heart, but meanwhile, that no good Gaston made a horrible plan to marry Belle. Ugh, that good for nothing, heartless, evil Gaston. That slimy, creepy, crawly Gaston. That horrible looking
Koki. Whoa, settle down. Gaston is not real. I told you that.
Sorry about that, Polly. My bad.
Sorry about that, viewers at home. Please forgive Koki. He really hates Gaston. Anyway, Belle didn't know what to do, but luckily she met up with Lumiere, Cosworth, and all the other servants in the castle, and they did a nice song called Be Our Guest.
Ooh, I love that song. I love to hear that song while I'm eating.
Yeah, that was the greatest song ever.
Anyway, Belle had a good time with Lumiere, Cosworth, Chip, Mrs. Potts, and all their friends. But Belle decided to go to the West Wing, which is the Beast's room, and she found the Enchanted Rose. But the Beast came, and he was angry with Belle, and Belle ran away. But Belle, along with Philippe the horse, met up with the wolves again.
Oh no, not the wolves! Bad doggies! Bad doggies!
Yeah, but luckily, the Beast came and saved Belle and Philippe's life. Go, Beast, go!
Thanks to the Beast saving Belle's life, the Beast and Belle became good friends.
Yeah, they had great time together with Lumiere, Cosworth, Chip, and all the servants at the castle. Heck, they even danced together at the ballroom while Mrs. Potts sang the song called Beauty and the Beast. Wow, look at them go, dancing together. How amazing.
It was all fun and games for Beauty and the Beast, but when the Beast showed Belle the magic mirror, Belle asked the mirror to see her father, and her father was stuck in the blizzard looking for her.
Yeah, it was all fun and games for Belle and the Beast, but Beast had to let Belle go so Belle can rescue her father in the nick of time. Belle managed to take Maurice home, but many villagers came, so they wanted to take Maurice to the loony bin, but Belle refuses and used the magic mirror to show them the Beast. They were angry and made an angry mob. A deadly angry mob, I tell you. A very deadly... Whoa, Koki, calm down. Okay, calm down. You're getting enough craziness as much as it is. Oh, man, not again. Sorry about that, Broomhilda.
Gaston led the angry mob to the castle, but luckily the servants of the castle came and beat up the angry mob.
Yeah, that's right, Polly. But Gaston came to the West Wing and began to beat up the Beast like crazy. I mean, it was just horrible for the Beast because he was so sad for Belle. But luckily, Belle came back and the Beast defeated Gaston. But Gaston stabbed the Beast in the back. Ooh, maybe Gaston likes some Caesar salad. But luckily, Gaston fell to his terrible death.
The Beast was about to die, but luckily, thanks to Belle's love for him, he turned back into a human along with the other servants, and they lived happily ever after. The end.
Oh, Polly, that's just wonderful, man. Hooray! We finally did the movie review of Beauty and the Beast. Now we can take our Halloween costumes off.
Hey, what's going on? The Halloween costumes are still stuck on us. Oh no!
What? Really? Oh no! I'm so sorry!
Cry mode activate. My life has no meaning. My life has no meaning. Boo-hoo.
Oh, Broomhilda, don't cry.
Yeah, don't cry, Broomhilda. And Robo Cauldron, you two did your best. Oh, don't cry. I can't help it, Polly and Koki. I am so sorry. I didn't mean for this to happen in October.
Oh, man, she's really sad.
Yeah, maybe we could cheer her up with ice cream or something. I mean, witches love ice cream, right? Don't you think so, Polly?
Hey, Broomhilda, cheer up. Maybe we'll give you some ice cream. Hey, what's happening to me? What's happening to me? It's happening again, just like in October.
Been kissed by a witch.
Me too.
about that, Polly and Koki. I just couldn't resist. I just love happy endings.
Me too, Broomhilda. Me too. I just love happy endings too.
Yeah, I know how you feel, you guys. I love happy endings too. Oh well, let us know in the comments which movie should we review next, and we'll see you all next time.
Adios, goodbye, au revoir, au revoir, and all kinds of goodbye stuff, goodbye. Hey, let me have a kiss too. Pucker up, give me a kiss, give me a kiss.
What? Oh no!
Oh no!